leading scorer and rebounder for Cincinnati. Terry Nelson, Corey Blunt, Anthony Buford, and Nick Van Exel. And a look at the Michigan huddle. Michigan in the visiting uniform since they had the lower seed to get here. They were a six out of the Southeast, while Cincinnati was a four seed out of the Midwest. Steve Fisher in the huddle, 11-1 in the NCAA tournament, coaching today against Bob Huggins in his third season at Cincinnati. Now the officials for game one, Ed Hightower from Alton, Illinois, Don Rutledge from Windermere, Florida, and Jim Burr from Latham, New York.
And Jim, I would say all three of those men going to have their hands full today. These two teams came out. There's a little jabbering between the two. They have, of course, even though they have not played yet this year, there is somewhat of a rivalry between the great club that they came from Michigan, and the great Big Ten situation, and maybe somewhat of an underrated and underknown Cincinnati bunch.
Corey Blunt and Chris Weber start the final four with the Bearcats in control, and Nick Van Exel.
One steps to the outside. They don't play a man in the low post, taking up a lot of space there. They want to have a lot of room. That's offense.
He wrapped his arm right around Juwan Howard, and it's called against Cincinnati on the first trip.
But Blunt showed that he's not afraid to put that ball on the floor and make a move. And here comes the press. Matching up with Buford, looking to pick off any long pass.
Jalen Rose doubled up, gets it over to Howard, and a steal right away. Van Exel. He'll shoot two.
Tim Van Exel's had a great NCAA tournament. And what he did there is what he does so well when he penetrates. He used his body to lean in on Howard, who is an excellent shot blocker. But here it is, the first time they turn the ball over on Jalen Rose. Juwan Howard cannot get to it, and here comes quickness. Van Exel takes it right to the hoop. Howard, who's quick for a big man. Now watch this lean in. He takes the ball right into Howard and then makes it impossible for him to block it.
Two for Van Exel. He's a transfer from Trinity Junior College in Texas. He had 22 against Memphis State when they blew out Memphis State in the Midwest Final.
Neither club a solid free throw shooting team. Here's the pickup. Trapping off even missed free throws.
Jimmy King.
Straight man to man.
Howard Nelson goes inside. Weber. Oh, nice. Turnaround. Half hook.
And Jim, if Nelson is going to allow Weber to get the ball that low, he has no chance. He's given up about 3 inches and a lot of leaping ability. Notice total movement. Nobody in the low post stationary.
Buford, three-pointer. Weber comes right out of it, and it's stolen away from him. Cincinnati will score for the first time on a slam dunk.
What's made this team so great is their ability to go ahead and press out of any situation. That was a missed field goal, and they were still there to press. Weber's got to learn he cannot put the ball on the floor in that backcourt area against this team.
It was Terry Nelson on the jam, and that ball deflected out of bounds. It belongs to Michigan.
Jim, another thing you've noticed so far, Cincinnati has been able to force Michigan to send the ball down the sidelines. That's exactly what they want. Michigan's got to figure out a way to get the ball to the center of the floor.
Ray Jackson touching it for the first time. Here's Weber out high. Oh, they challenged Howard. He'll take it in the lane, give it up to Weber. Again,
beautiful half hook. You know, we haven't even seen Chris Weber use that shot very often. Jim, we've covered him a number of times this year. He usually shoots the turnaround jumper or takes it to the hoop for the dunk.
Van Exel uses a screen from Blunt and hits the jumper. He's shooting 67% from outside in the tournament. And after missing the two free throws, he redeems himself from the outside.
There is Jones, an excellent defender, playing in the backcourt, a little more size.
Wide open is Weber. Couple of fakes. Well, he had three players sail in the air, and the last one fouled him.
pretty good job by Nelson, though, because instead of giving up a dunk, and he said he is not going to give up any dunks to Weber, he puts Weber on the foul line where he has just now gone over the 50% mark as a free throw shooter.
What was it Nelson said? He'll be on the floor before he dunks it, if I'm
That's
in the
right.
area.
He said he'd be looking up at me.
Weber even told me yesterday at practice, he says, I've been reading all this stuff and hearing all week that Cincinnati says I'm not going to be a factor in this game. He's hit a couple of field goals, but misses both free throws.
And there it is. You took away 100% opportunity on the dunk, put him on the line, and Michigan comes up with zero. I don't sense any intimidation out here on the part of Michigan against this Cincinnati club.
Three-pointer, bingo for Nick Van Exel.
Jim, not only is he shooting over 60% in the tournament, that started with the great Midwest tournament, so he's on some roll.
Jimmy King comes right back to tie it at seven.
Bob Huggins upset with that. When that ball gets down the corner, he wants not only somebody playing Jimmy King, he'd like to have a double team down there.
Herb Jones, their leading scorer, has not put up a shot so far. Forced it inside, perhaps, or Buford wasn't ready for it, and Michigan forces the turnover.
Pretty solid defense by Ray Jackson, who came off that outstanding defensive performance against Jimmy Jackson.
King, he's hit one already. Make it two.
Number one three-point shooter for Michigan.
Michigan is 4-for-4 from the floor at the Final Four.
Blunt. Good pass.
Yep, gives it up to Van Exel, and Van Exel now has 7 of Cincinnati's 9 points.
I was surprised Howard didn't go after him on that play.
Rose penetrating and scoring for the first time today.
Jim, he's so tough at 6'8 when he penetrates. He's got that ability to go up with that little leaner left-hander of his.
Our first whistle under 16, an official timeout, game one at the national semifinals.
Customers demand high quality and low price. They don't want a trade-off, they want it all.
My grandfather had this philosophy, I have this philosophy. We give everybody the best quality they can have at the best possible price.
With ProWatch, you get the whole package. AT&T quality and a competitive price.
We have papaya from Hawaii, we have blood oranges from Italy, clementines from Morocco. We have cheese from almost every country that has a cow.
With AT&T ProWatch, the more he calls, the higher the discount.
I've got enough headaches keeping my business going 12 hours a day, 14 hours a day, and I can't be worried about my long distance service.
AT&T has clear connections, quality fax, and the calls go through faster.
The quality isn't there, it's not a problem.
We have an expression, delivery truck goes two ways. If it isn't all quality, it goes back to where it came from.
You build up trust through years and years of delivering value.
We can make a difference. AT&T, call us.
Service to more cities across the Atlantic than any other U.S. airline, Delta now makes it easier than ever for the people of America to get to know the people of Europe.
Buongiorno.
Bonjour.
Via.
Guten Tag. Grüezi.
Delta.
Здравствуйте.
Freedom. It's the spirit which moves the Cutlass Supreme, a car intelligently engineered to free your eyes, your hands, your senses. Introducing the new Oldsmobile Cutlass Supreme. The look may change, but the spirit remains the same. Oldsmobile, the power of intelligent engineering.
The Oldsmobile drive to the Final Four Cellathon. It's your best shot for a great deal now.
A car crash traps a young girl in a blazing inferno.
She was pinned in. I needed help. I needed a miracle.
Rescue 911 Tuesday.
Back in the Metrodome, the last thing Bob Huggins told his team was to keep their composure, that eventually the trapping would get to Michigan. Anthony Buford said they like to play defense because all the traps and steals lead to alley-oops and dunks. Jim?
Well, that was how they scored their first basket, a steal and a dunk for Nelson. Only one missed shot in this game. Cincinnati 4 out of 5. Michigan 5 for 5. Martin has come into the game for Cincinnati. Eric Martin.
Good rub off by Van Exel. He didn't get the ball. Jimmy King cannot afford to allow him to rub off that way.
Van Exel.
He'll beat him.
Oh.
Turned it over. Watch Jalen Rose look over this defense. Try to get the ball in the middle somehow.
Oh, tough pass.
That's going for the home run ball too early. Got to flash guys up to the top of the key, get the ball in the middle, and then break down the defense. Van Exel has some quickness on Jimmy King. You know it, Jim?
You've already seen that. He could have fired up a three on the last trip where he turned it over. That's out of bounds belonging to Cincinnati.
Ray Jackson, an excellent defender. And against Jones, who is one of the best post-up players in college basketball, Jackson just beat him to the spot.
Anthony Buford with the ball. He played for Huggins at Akron and then transferred. Played for him for 2 years. Driving and laying it up short. Weber spots the break opportunity, and Jackson lost it. Weber's right there. Blunt pulls it down. Cincinnati wants a break. Buford with Rose shouldering him, and Rose is called for the foul. Well, repeat champions, Billy. It hasn't happened since 1973 with UCLA, but Cincinnati pulled it off in 61 and 62, celebrating the 30-year anniversary of that last championship.
And of course, during that time, beat the great Jerry Lucas Ohio State teams and had a chance to become the first three-peat college basketball club, and got beat by Loyola in that great overtime game.
And Duke will be trying to duplicate that back-to-back, as UCLA last did it in 73, and they'll be playing Indiana later tonight. Jeff Scott has come in for the Bearcats, replacing Blunt, and here comes the pressure.
Well, you can see that Bob Huggins is very confident with that bench of his. He's going to go 9 deep today. He's going to use those fellas quite a bit, and that puts some pressure on Steve Fisher to start thinking about his bench early on in this game.
Howard finds a slashing King, and he is fouled by Jeff Scott, who just entered the game.
If Michigan will get the ball to the center instead of going down the side as they did right there, they're going to be able to go ahead and work very well against this press.
Ray Jackson inbounding. Great defensive player, Billy. And Herb Jones, who he's guarding, has not been a factor so far. Cincinnati's leading scorer. Oh,
good
Rose.
Steal.
Got it right
Henry
back.
Steal. Now, this is an area on the floor, particularly with Corey Blunt not in the game, where Michigan can take advantage if they can get the game in the paint. Blunt's coming right back in.
Scott's been in the game, Billy, for a minute, and he's already been assessed two.
Well, I don't think he's got, let's see if he's taken, yeah, he is taking Scott out. I thought maybe that Bob Huggins might try to get big there and play Scott together with Blunt.
Howard, turnaround over Jones.
Oh, look at Van Exel get up.
You said he's quick, Billy. He can leap. Martin coming on a wing, tries to get it over to Jones. Wolverines race ahead. Tough pass. Weber trying to go inside to Howard.
Well, that we've seen Chris Weber on the break try to make a play that's not quite the calculated pass you want to make at this stage in the game. It's kind of like Rose's long pass. I mean, it was there, but he didn't have to make it quite so such a fancy play. Now watch the screen off the top. A scissors play. Looking to hit the guards down low.
Jones on the baseline. He's doubled up. Weber blocks it out of bounds.
Now Weber will have a little something to say. Jones on the way by. Don't bring that stuff in here.
A little jawing during the warm-ups, Billy.
Well, actually, I'm kind of surprised. They started out in the warm-ups really talking to each other, but they haven't in the game so far.
Nice move by Buford over the taller defender.
Buford averaging a little over 15 a game.
Jimmy King, he'll pull up and nail it. Oh, he's hot at the start. That's a two for King, and he's 3 for 3 from the floor, including a couple of threes.
An excellent jump shooter from the outside. He's getting more and more confidence as the year goes on. Well, good change off the pass. Chris Rubber was lucky that he got a piece of that one because Martin had an easy layup.
Which freshman will be replaced first? Yeah, and Weber a moment ago telling Cincinnati, what a great picture.
Well, you know,
Bob Fishman telling him to zip it up, guys, telling Cincinnati, I'm sure.
Well, you know, he really has a lot of emotion in the game, Jim, and I think a lot of times it's emotion within himself. He might have been talking to himself, say, let's get back to the game.
Alan Jackson handling the ball in for the first time for Cincinnati. Michael Talley has come in for Michigan, replacing Jalen Rose. Rose, the first freshman to sit. Jones!
Well, he hasn't had any luck taking the ball inside on Jackson, so he shoots from a standstill jumper.
Good idea. That was a three. Weber, right past two Bearcats who could have stolen it.
Well, that pass was intended for Howard. He didn't get his hands up in time, and it went all the way through to Chris Weber, who was on the ball enough to be ready to make the catch. And I thought Steve Fisher would go to that bench, bring some of those experienced players in. It's going to take more than a starting team to win this one.
Second chance opportunity. Stolen away. No, they won't get that chance. Talley will take the middle. Dish it to King.
360.
Followed up by Jackson.
Buford will take it at him.
Oh, Weber. He was trying to draw the charge. He just weaved his way right around him.
Well, Buford now has taken it against Weber. Penexel has taken it against Howard, so they're not afraid to take it inside, even the guards. Back in. That should be a goaltend. That should be a goaltend. Yes, sir.
We're going to talk about it first. Jim Burr says yes from midcourt. That counts goaltending and a foul.
Without question, the foul was committed. And what might have happened in that particular case, the minute that the foul was called, Martin might have gone up there not realizing that the play had not ended because it was an obvious goaltend.
Two on Blunt and two on Scott. The inside guys for Cincinnati, and they brought in Terrence Gibson. Bob Huggins' first signee. Scott bouncing back off the bench in for Blunt.
Jim, that could be a real serious problem. And you'd like to be, if you're Bob Huggins, an opportunity to stay as big as possible. You don't want Michigan to be able to play volleyball on that rim.
Officials timeout with 11:58 to go in the first half. The Wolverines by one.
These extinct relics of American business remind us that waste and inefficiency don't pay. And that while perhaps it used to be impressive to throw money around, today it's more impressive not to. A timely reminder from the only company that guarantees 10:30 overnight delivery for up to 40% less. UPS.
This is our vision of what a luxury sedan should be. Not because it offers rich leather and anti-lock brakes, but because it comes standard with an airbag on the driver's side and the passenger side as well. Creating a luxury sedan where even peace of mind is shared. The new 929. The first luxury sedan from the new Mazda.
It just feels right.
It is one of the most rigorously tested fluids on Earth, relentlessly measured for maximum protection against the friction, the heat and stress of today's engines. It is today's Quaker State. The Big Q is one tough motor oil.
A car with a worn suspension is more than uncomfortable. It's unsafe. But Midas puts you back in control. For a limited time, buy one Shocker Strut and get the second for 50% off. For a safer suspension, nobody beats Midas.
Why did Hertz invent number one club goal service? To beat the rush hour.
See, every plane and everybody seems to land at once. But with goal service,
There are no counters and no paperwork. You go nonstop to your car with your name in lights.
Hertz, number one club goal.
The best reason yet why Hertz beats the rush hour. Call Hertz today for low daily rates on Lincolns with free unlimited mileage.
He heard voices that made him kill their daughter. He says he's all better. Would you let him go free? 48 Hours, Wednesday.
Jimmy, want to see what it looks like to play against a tough press? Michael Talley sees everybody coming, throws it, fires it right for Howard. It's an errant pass, goes by Howard, but look at the ever-alert Chris Webber, grabs it and dunks it on through. So Talley had the right idea, and it turned out to be the right play, even though it was an accident.
Blistering pace, over 60% for both teams from the floor.
Double low post.
Gibson, good bounce pass inside to Jones.
Smart by Jackson to pick that dribble up and get it backwards. He was going right into the teeth of the trap.
Michael Talley gives it up to Webber.
We got a change in the defense now by Cincinnati. They're playing a matchup zone and trapping out of that. Oh, beautiful.
Great move. He never caught it. He just tapped it over to Webber, who has eight. But Juwan Howard to Webber. And Wolverines lead by three.
Jim, in that zone, Cincinnati is very, very small. Jones is listed at 6'5". He's probably closer to 6'3". The guards are small now, and Martin's 6'5". So Michigan can throw right over the top of the zone.
Martin got it right back.
Hey, can you believe Cincinnati taking it to him on the boards?
Talley makes the fake. Oh, good rejection by Jackson. Allen Jackson. Gibson on the wing. Oh, Scott could be. Yep, Scott's a hit with his third. Jeff Scott.
Now they're really going to be small because Nelson, you can't afford to put Blunt back into the game. He's got two. So now Nelson comes in to be the tallest player on the floor. This is going to be a very difficult couple of minutes for Bob Huggins' club.
That's 16 fouls. You see Terry Nelson back in, the team comedian at Cincinnati.
And Steve Fisher has not yet had to use Eric Riley, so he can get even bigger if he wants to go to the bench.
Howard, jumper. Followed up by Rose.
Jim, they're too big with this lineup on the floor.
Van Exel has come back in at the point.
Now you say on the other end of the floor, why not create a mismatch? The problem, Nelson, not a scorer.
Talley pushed off. His first, team foul number three.
See, they're just playing right over the top now. Good block out by Nelson, but no way for the small guards to handle Rose, who's 6'8", playing at the guard position. Bob Huggins' worst nightmare, get his big people where he was going to have a problem matching up anyway in such early foul trouble.
Van Exel, three-pointer. Webber now with four rebounds.
See what else is tough now with Talley, King, and Rose in the game. They have three ball handlers.
Talley, oh, what a nice move that is. Talley, who has really been one guy frustrated by the curtailed playing time. He has started some this season, getting some minutes here and looking good.
Jimmy had a great game against Indiana this year. 3 for 4 threes. He had 15 points in the game. Obviously a guy who knows what starting's all about. He was there at Michigan in the past.
Almost stole it to Talley. And King punched up ahead to King. Jones, oh, he's lucky. Van Exel hustled also. Jones takes it into the second row of photographers. Buford, three-pointer. That ends a 9-0 run by Michigan.
Well, Cincinnati really needed that play, and you just think it could have gone the other way because Michigan just was an inch or so away from being able to have a layup.
Yeah, Van Exel really made a play there coming back down, Billy.
Now watch this. They're trying to match up a little bit. Nice play by Martin.
Martin denying. Jones on the break. And he'll shoot two. Herb Jones, great hustle, but also trailing was Van Exel.
Well, Jim, he probably should have taken that ball with him out of bounds, because by tapping it back in, Michigan had two men there. If it had not been a big play by Van Exel, Michigan has an easy layup. He'd have been better off just taking it with him. Here comes Riley. Now, here's where Michigan really has an advantage. Out goes Howard. In comes an even bigger Riley, and we know how well he played in the NCAA tournament in the key win over Oklahoma State.
Had his best numbers of the season in that game. 15 points, 10 rebounds. Jimmy King was hit with the foul, and Jones will shoot one more. Top junior college in the country in 1990 out of Butler Junior College in Kansas. And Jones, the shooter, comes out. Gibson returns. They call Terrence Gibson instant defense. You often hear instant offense is a nickname. I remember Benny Anders used to be known as that.
Wait, really, you know, Steve Fisher doing something here that I think is very smart. He's got three guards really in the game right now, two big men on the inside. Here's that 2-3 matchup. So he's got a lot of good ball handling.
Grazed off the fingertips of Cincinnati. Michigan has it.
The other thing he gets is both King and Jalen Rose playing, in effect, wing positions are going to be dangerous rebounders.
8:33 to go in the first half. Michigan 25, Cincinnati 23. The winner plays Monday in the championship game. Rose goes through the defenders. Oh.
He is so good at that jump stop, jump shot as he penetrates. You know, you're coming right at the basket. It's very difficult to have any good perception on that shot. Normally it's hit off the back of the rim, but he's perfect with it. Riley on Nelson. He can afford to drop out and help block some shots here. He knows Nelson's not looking for his shot.
Van Exel fired it inside. Nelson able to get it back. Hold against Weber.
Now Martin has got a quick first step. He's an excellent leaper on the second jump, and he just went right to Chris Weber.
That's the first against Weber. Team foul number five.
What? See how quick Martin was with that first step. Weber lays out.
An official's timeout.
A tradition unlike any other. The Masters on CBS.
Even with shift on the fly four-wheel drive. Track independent front suspension and a rugged fuel-injected V6. There are still some places you'd never dream of taking your family unless you owned a Toyota 4Runner. Go ahead, put yourself out there.
Tie game back after this. Twist off 7-Up caps and win as the Uncola celebrates the 100th year of basketball. Collect all the 7-Up caps you can, because if you spell Y-E-A-R, you'll win a $10,000 college scholarship or win a Spalding mini basketball instantly. So collect your Uncola caps and win. 7-Up employees not eligible.
Win part of $1 million in scholarships from 7-Up, the Uncola.
Gonna get you. Gonna look you right in the face. Better get yourself together, darling. Join the human race. How in the world are you gonna see? Laughing at fools like me. Who on earth do you think you are? A superstar? Well, right you are.
You're watching CBS Sports coverage of the Final Four.
The last 6 months, this building has housed the World Series, the Super Bowl, and now the Final Four. And at the 7:52 mark to go in the first half, game summary, Billy, Michigan 63%, Cincinnati 47.
Well, what's amazing about that is Cincinnati has done a great job holding opponents to just 41% so far in the tournament. And whenever they outshoot their opponents, they're 21-0. So at this point, you can see why they're just down four.
Jim Nance and Billy Packer from Minneapolis, Indiana, and Duke. The second game of our doubleheader.
Yeah, look at how small this club is on the floor right now for Cincinnati. Nelson and Martin are going to have to get it done inside. Buford actually playing a forward spot.
Foul outside on Ray Jackson. You said Martin and Nelson would have to do it inside. They're both 6'5", Billy. They're the biggest players on the court right now for Cincinnati.
As I said, Buford's lined up now with Jackson. That helps Michigan a little bit in the fact that they get their best defender on the most dangerous player out there now.
First on Jackson. Each team has committed 16 fouls, so one away from the bonus.
Cincinnati showing good patience here, Jim. Occupying the clock, making the bigger Michigan team have to really work on defense.
Martin steps past Weber.
That could be a huge call. That's going to be Ronnie that went down. They're going to call him for getting over underneath. Basket counts. This is an excellent move by Martin. He goes right by, and that official was all over it, Jim. Ronnie just, he did not have position.
I was surprised how easy it was to get past Weber. He had one quick dart, and he was on his way to a three-point opportunity.
Well, I talked about that explosive move he made on Weber just a time or two ago. Chris is going to have to sit down to play Martin. And the press stays on, pulling that zone out a little bit. They've got the break.
This will tie it at 27. Terrence Gibson with the layup.
Excellent job by Bob Huggins' club.
A 9-2 run for the Bearcats. And a foul on Martin, who pushed off. Talley will be the shooter. He'll shoot a 1-1. Steve Fisher, 11-1 in the tournament.
Well, you notice some other fellas on that list we'll probably see a little bit more of today. Mike Krzyzewski. Bob Knight.
He says the most important win of them all was his first when he stepped in the tournament and had a struggle against Xavier. He said, had I lost the Xavier game, I never would have been the coach. Never would have hired me. Juwan Howard has come in for Michigan. This 9-2 run and looking to take the lead. Buford. Oh, on a tip.
That's Martin. See how quickly he gets up on that second leap?
And Gibson gives the Bearcats the lead.
Martin is really playing great basketball. Talley's got to go backwards with this ball some. Here comes the trap.
Ray Jackson. He was hit with the body by Martin. His second, team foul number 8. The Michigan team composition. And really, the only senior that plays is Freddie Hunter, a former walk-on. Jimmy King back in. Jackson at the line for 2.
Jim, the guy that's really doing it for Cincinnati is Eric Martin. He was a co-MVP with Blunt in junior college. He hasn't had any great number type games, but he's very solid, and today he's showing what he can do inside, and they really need him with both Scott and Blunt on the bench.
Again, a teammate, as Billy mentioned, of Corey Blunt at Rancho Santiago Junior College.
And he gets it alive again.
Yep. 1-point lead for Cincinnati and possession.
Michigan has been thrown out of sync with this press.
Martin again getting past Weber. Short on the off the glass.
And that was Blunt that was up there to keep the ball alive.
Offensive. They got him with the elbow. Howard.
One of the things that Bob Huggins has done with the press is that can attack you at any time. It attacks on missed shots. It attacks on made shots, Mr. Made foul shots. Now watch this right here. They stay right with the press. Normally, and a good call by the official, normally a team would break down at that point and get back on defense, but Cincinnati keeps it right in your face. The Michigan players are going to have to get used to that, throw the ball backwards, get in the hands of their guards as quickly as they can.
That's two on Juwan Howard. Herb Jones back in for Cincinnati. That ball deflected by Jimmy King, who was defending the inbounds pass. Jackson will dunk it home for a one-point Michigan lead.
Much smarter play by Weber. Just make the good fundamental two-handed chest pass to the following Jackson. Van Exel really posts up well, but he's just not getting him the ball on his cuts.
King knocked it out of his hands. The first sentence of the preseason media guide at the University of Cincinnati says,
no more talk.
No more talk.
Don't
be worried about the talking. They've been warned about the talking.
But, Jim, we thought this would be the game of the great debate. It hasn't been quite as physical as I anticipated, but there is a lot of jabbering and a nice piece of officiating there to say, hey, let's play the game.
Riley in for Weber.
Man-to-man out of bounds.
Buford missing. Two Bearcats fight for it. Oh, and Van Exel let Howard pick it up.
And here comes trapping
but
again.
He read that one all the way. Van Exel.
Jalen Rose starting to get annoyed, I think, out here in the fact that he's not had the ball in his hands, which is exactly what Cincinnati wanted to do to this club. There he is. Get the ball back out to the man that can get something accomplished. Check out the defense. Matching up in the zone.
Oh, they deny it again and take it away. Martin will wait.
Not good spacing there, Jim. Jalen threw that ball from so far out in the low post against quicker people.
Buford, beautiful for Buford.
Now that's a young man from Flint, Michigan that wasn't recruited by one Big Ten school. He's got a little bit to prove today.
So Wisconsin sent him a letter, but no one really showed him any interest. Rose, short, and Jones has it. Oh, not for long. Ray Jackson right back for Michigan. Rose missing, Riley saving, no, on the line. Television timeout under four. 31-30, Cincinnati.
Want to run your windowing software fast? Then you need a real power source inside. A source that can generate the power your software needs. The affordable Intel 486. Power it up and run your software at light speed. Intel, the computer inside.
Wyatt Earp.
Mister, I'm taking you in.
Marshall, isn't the fella entitled to a last meal?
Folks everywhere are heading to McDonald's for the return of the Wild West. Cause for a limited time, you can rustle up the sassy two-fisted McRib, smothered in barbecue sauce on a fresh homestyle bun.
Ma'am, that was mighty tasty. I'll need an order to go.
What you yes, want is what you get.
At McDonald's today.
Don't you know it's not polite to talk with your mouth full?
Introducing United Airlines' renowned international service to cities throughout Latin America. Come fly the airline that's uniting the world. Come fly the friendly skies.
We'll be right back.
Academy Award winner.
I've just created something totally illogical.
Kevin Costner, Field of Dreams, Sunday.
Well, this building yesterday had 33,000 fans in attendance for practice. Jim Nance and Billy Packer with you at game one. What do you think so far, Billy?
Well, I'm very impressed with Cincinnati's press, Jim. They force 20 turnovers a game. They pick up about 9 steals a game. What they've been able to do right now, as you can see, Michigan's had 29 possessions. Cincinnati's been able to put the press on 16 times in various ways, and it's resulted in 5 turnovers. So they're right on target. And what they've also been able to do with the press is keep the ball out of Jalen Rose's hands so that they can't get working in the paint against Cincinnati's team that is much smaller.
I was about to say before, their media guide started the season by saying this is a team that's an unknown entity, and that certainly has been the case. They're still unknown somewhat, even at the Final Four. Van Exel. That was very smooth, wasn't it?
He's on a roll. Yes, he let Jimmy King know that he just faked him out and got that jumper off. Not a good place to pick up your dribble.
They said it was contact from Buford.
Jim, against the press, and you know where the pressure points are going to be, just as you cross half court. So if you're Jalen Rose, you cannot pick up your dribble at that spot because you have no alternative then. Howard was coming to him, but he didn't have a good position.
First on view for team foul number 9, so it's a 1-1 for Juwan Howard.
Played his big offensive game of the year against Indiana this year. Solid defender.
Remember how we speculated had Eric Montross signed with Michigan instead of North Carolina and followed in his father's footsteps? May it perhaps altered the future Fab Five signing? I talked to Howard about that. He says, yeah, probably would have altered my decision to come to Michigan.
And then who knows what would have happened, Jim?
Weber in for the shooter.
As Howard was the catalyst that brought Weber and Rose, King, and Jackson.
He was the first to sign. He signed in November of 90. Before his senior season in high school.
Jones playing way out on top. It looks like they're going to try to get Buford and Van Exel a ball. Nice.
Oh, nice teamwork. Passing in the paint and back to a 3-point lead.
Well, when Cincinnati was destroyed by Indiana earlier in the year, another trap.
And Van Exel, great pass to Jones. Right off the line.
Oh, sensational play.
Largest lead of the day for Cincinnati.
There's Rose picking the ball up. Boy, they have really taken Michigan out of their half-court set.
Van Exel with a push-off. And there are a few words exchanged with King and Van Exel.
See, right there is the trapping point. Michigan's running exactly into the area that Cincinnati likes. And you start talking about an incredible catch and put back by Herb Jones. Watch this. He goes right over the top, puts it back up the right hand. Beautiful play.
First foul against Nick Van Exel, so number 10 on Cincinnati. So that means a double bonus situation. 2 free throws for Jimmy King.
Jim, if Michigan's going to offset the press, they cannot get themselves to cross half-court area right into corners and get the double team just as Cincinnati wants. They've got to get the ball to the center of the floor and not be so anxious to attack the press. Make the press work at least one pass.
Jimmy King, Mr. Texas basketball last year in high school, out of Plano, and he hits them both to cut the lead to 3. 10 for King.
Jimmy King right now has his hands full with Van Exel, is as hot as any guard in the tournament.
And he's trying another 3, but Weber, big time rebound. His 5th. And Jackson led Rose too much.
And Jim, you notice how few times today Jalen Rose has been the man that has the ball in his hands.
Indiana and Duke about 30 minutes after this one finishes.
Cincinnati's number one piece of strategy when we talk to Bob Huggins is to keep it out of Rose's hands, and they have done a great job of that in this first half. Very unselfish team is Cincinnati.
Huggins been coaching for 10 years, said it's the most unselfish group he's ever had. Good pass by Van Exel. Baseline, easy shot for Terry Nelson.
Nelson is not going to look to score often. That's about his range in the jumper, but he doesn't take bad shots.
But again, it was Van Exel with the assist. Not only scoring, but setting up his teammates as well.
You notice when they get a trap, they don't necessarily give up on it. Here it comes. Buford stays right with the trap.
King could set up a break for the Bearcats.
They have taken Michigan right out of the game with the trap.
Oh, and Rose was just planted, and they went right by him.
Jim, we wondered if there would ever be a cracking point for these freshmen. They're seeing a type of game that they have not seen. They do not control the tempo of this game, nor the way it is to be played, and it's really thrown them off stride.
Irv Jones' dunk makes it a 7-point margin. King in and out. Weber on the follow. Oh, missed the layup. Riley's there, however.
Well, when the ball gets down in the paint where Michigan wants it, they can score.
Final minute of the first half.
They're going to hold for one. Good job.
Michigan had gone 4.5 minutes without a field goal before that shot by Riley.
How about Buford telling everybody what to do? What a leader out here.
They call him Coach.
Yep.
And he has the ball now, Buford. It's a 14-second differential, as you can see.
Think they'd like to see Herb Jones get that ball down the low post, or just a clear out?
Jones driving.
Two seconds.
2 seconds on the shot clock. They reset it as it goes out of bounds to five.
Well, And the thing, Jim, is going to be interesting here. I think they've got time for Van Exel clearing out.
We see Vosko come in for Michigan.
And Steve Fisher did a wise thing, reminding his club that it is back to 5 seconds. Look for Van Exel to rub off here.
Nelson right back to the inbounds pass from Martin.
Back to five.
Yeah. They're going to get the last shot of the half if they keep up at this pace.
I was looking for a rub-off, get Van Exel for the jumper and a side, but now he's taking the ball out of bounds. It's for Buford.
Three-pointer. Oh. Tip by Nelson. Nelson almost got it for a second time. And Weber up ahead.
Oh, Jim, there's no. There is no way. What happened to all the time? Is that possible that they had that much time?
Yeah. Pretty good effort from three-quarter court, too.
Those 5 seconds extra helped Michigan.
Cincinnati 41, Michigan 38. We'll be right back from the Final Four.
For the last time, name the secret ingredient that gives Diet Pepsi an unfair advantage.
Uh-huh.
Well, what is it?
It's like this, baby. You know it's uh-huh, cause the taste says uh-huh, baby.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
You got the right one, baby.
With 100% uh-huh.
Okay, now let's meet the stars of the other game in town. The Oldsmobile Drive to the Final Four Celebi.
Where the deals and values are spectacular on every new Oldie. Example, the new Achieva with Smart Lease. Just $199 per month for 48 months and no down payment gets you an Achieva. With anti-lock brakes, automatic transmission, and air. The game clock is running, so net a great deal now.
At an airport counter, two cops charge you with being a drug dealer. You're not. Yeah, prove it. All they've got to do is suspect it. 60 Minutes, Sunday.
It's back-to-back Bert. Two great shows, one hilarious hour.
And yes, I can do both at the same time.
First, little Emily's left home alone.
Oh, is she sleeping?
She was the last time we saw her.
Then, will guest star Robbie Benson help the coach win his first game?
Calm down, though. It's the big time.
An hour of Evening Shade Monday.
All those who love great comedy, say hi.
We'll return with the Prudential at the half after this message and a word from your local station. You're watching CBS Sports coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship.
CBS Sports coverage of the 1992 NCAA Basketball National Semifinal Game is sponsored by Mercedes-Benz, engineered like no other car in the world. United, come fly the airline that's uniting the world. Come fly the friendly skies. And by McDonald's, what you want is what you get at McDonald's today.
Mercedes-Benz automobiles represent decades of durability testing. Leading-edge technology, plus one reassurance you're unlikely to find in many other cars, seats actually designed to withstand the energy of a rear impact. That's just one of the many virtues that makes a test drive worth your time, and a Mercedes-Benz well worth the difference.
It is one of the most rigorously tested fluids on Earth, relentlessly measured for maximum protection against the friction, the heat and stress of today's engines. It is today's Quaker State. The Big Q is One Tough Motor Oil.
Thank you, Doctor.
I'm not a real doctor, but if I were, I'd recommend Ligamen for occasional muscle pain.
Still going. Nothing outlasts the Energizer. They keep going and going.
This is CBS.
Before you try anything new on an Alaska Airlines flight, we try it first.
Too spicy?
Too spicy.
Too spicy.
More?
More.
More?
More.
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 Too far.
Too far?
Too far.
Too far.
Still too spicy?
Still too spicy.
Still too spicy.
Louder?
Louder.
Louder.
Louder?
Louder.
Louder.
Too loud.
Too loud.
Too loud.
Why does Alaska Airlines go to all this trouble? So you won't have to.
Prudential at the Half is sponsored by the Prudential. In a changing world, one thing remains rock solid. The Prudential.
It's a beautiful day in the Twin Cities area, but we'll give it to them. We're watching basketball inside. Cincinnati leads Michigan 41-38 at the half. Hi, good everybody. I'm Pat O'Brien along with my partner, Mike Francesa. Welcome to the Prudential at the half. And Cincinnati just took Michigan right out of this game.
You did, Pat. They took them out of the game. The traps worked. 12 Michigan turnovers, and I thought that Cincinnati was able to play small. They were quick, and what they showed was a lot of toughness. They took it right to the Wolverines in the first half.
It's Final Four time, Mike, as you know, yep. And that means it's also time for another rite of spring, the awarding of the Chevrolet MVPs.
Hi, I'm James Brown. Today we conclude this year's edition of the Chevrolet Scholarship Program with the presentation of the Chevrolet Player and Coach of the Year Awards as selected by the CBS Sports staff. With me to present the awards is Frank Rain from Chevrolet. Welcome, Frank.
Thanks, James. It's great to be with you again at another exciting Final Four. In this, our 22nd year, the Chevrolet Scholarship Program has topped the $4 million mark in contributions to the nation's colleges and universities. This program has been a long-term priority at Chevrolet because it represents an investment in the future of America. If this country is going to continue to excel, we need the leadership of today's brightest students. It's in this spirit of excellence and leadership that we're pleased to honor the best.
There are so many good candidates for Player of the Year. However, one stood tall all season long. Christian Laettner from Duke University. Christian is the epitome of a team player and leader. He is the ACC Player of the Year and on too many All-American teams to mention. Duke's senior co-captain hopes to leave with a flurry by leading Duke to their second straight national championship. A competitor on the court who can forget this game winner in the East Region Final against Kentucky.
Finds Christian Laettner with a 50-foot pass.
Congratulations, Christian. It's my pleasure to present you with this trophy as Chevrolet's Player of the Year.
Thank you very much. I feel very honored and privileged to receive this award. I'd like to thank the people at Chevrolet and also my coaching staff and my teammates. It is through them that I've been able to get this recognition.
And now the Coach of the Year winner, George Raveling from the University of Southern California. In his sixth year at USC, Coach Raveling led the Trojans to their first 20-win season since 1979 and a school record 15 conference victories. Coach Raveling was also named the Pac-10 Coach of the Year.
Congratulations, Coach Raveling. It's an honor and a pleasure to present you with this trophy as the Chevrolet Coach of the Year. And a check from Chevrolet in the amount of $2,500 to the USC General Scholarship Fund.
Thanks, Frank. To be the recipient of this award is a humble and yet exhilarating experience. On behalf of the University of Southern California and its basketball team, we would like to thank Chevrolet for this award and all it does for intercollegiate athletics.
Coach, let me add my congratulations to both you and to Christian. And Frank, thank you very much for your continued support of collegiate athletics and education through the Chevrolet Scholarship Program.
Well, as everybody's congratulating, we add ours as well. Of course, we'll see Christian Laettner in action in our second national semifinal as his Duke Blue Devils battle the Indiana Hoosiers. But next, we'll check in on the Michigan and Cincinnati locker rooms as At the Half rolls on from the Final Four on this fourth day of the fourth month here on CBS.
Gathered at racetracks from Silverstone to Watkins Glen. Why did something so many people love have to disappear? Coming April 20th, the return of the pure sports car, the new Mazda RX-7.
A mistake was made. Okay, we forgot. We overlooked it.
Say you need something sent overnight. There are a few companies you can call, but say you need it Saturday morning, guaranteed. There are two, but only one is so efficient.
Bobby, just give me a couple of minutes.
They get it there on time for far less, which is why to some, there is only one, UPS.
2 minutes, Gary. Yeah, you got 12,
who's 12?
40.
Yeah, let's go get them up.
Baby, let's go.
What do you get when you take a driving experience this pure and add 255 horsepower? Coming April 20th, the return of the pure sports car. The new Mazda RX-7.
Student athletes, role models, men and women striving for success in sport and success in life. As they travel the road to their own goals, they also show the way to others. Here are their stories. 13 men and women offering inspiration to student athletes of the future. The name of the game is life. To order, call 1-800-537-2684. This message provided by the NCAA.
Remember the excitement of the 1992 NCAA Final Four with the official souvenir program. To receive your copy, send $8 to Final Four Program, 904 North Broadway, Lexington, Kentucky, 40505. Please allow 4 to 6 weeks for delivery.
The drums of April here in the Metrodome. Cincinnati leads Michigan 41-38. Welcome back to the Prudential at the Halftime. Now to check in with our roving reporters are in the hallway, and so is Christian Laettner, who arrived here just a few moments ago, getting ready for his game. And our reporters are in those hallways as well. Let's check in now with JB. James?
All right, Pat, thank you very much. Michigan's worst fears occurred in the first half. That was not protecting the ball. Consider that Michigan turns the ball over 17 times a game, 12 in the first half here that led to 16 Cincinnati points. Give Cincy's defense an awful lot of credit. If Cincy wants to keep the ball out of the hands of Jalen Rose, they may get their wish, because Michael Talley, when he was at the point guard, was most effective for Michigan, moving Rose to the number two spot. A lot more patience on the offensive end. Getting back on defense is what Michigan is talking about right now. And right now, let's check down the other end of the hall with Leslie Visser.
JB, the folks at Cincinnati are happy with that defense. They forced 12 turnovers that led to 16 points. What they'd like offensively is to pass the ball a little more around the perimeter, get more touches on the ball. As for the verbal showboating, some call it trash talking, Terry Nelson said nothing he hasn't heard back home in L.A. It's home for you, Pat.
All right, Leslie, thank you. If you're Steve Fisher, what do you do to get your team back in this game?
Thanks, Pat. Patience versus the press in the second half and establish the inside game. That's where their strength is. That's where they have to go.
They're only down by three, too. The Wolverines or the Bearcats are one half away from a shot at the national title. And we'll find out as we rejoin Jim and Billy when our exclusive coverage of the Final Four continues here on CBS after a message and a word from your local station. Enjoy the second half.
The Prudential at the Half was sponsored by The Prudential. In a changing world, one thing remains rock solid. The Prudential. CBS Sports coverage of the 1992 NCAA Basketball National Semifinal Game is sponsored by Chevrolet, the cars and trucks more people depend on. Digital Equipment Corporation, and by Reebok, who asks, who is the world's greatest athlete, Dan or Dave?
Cincinnati 41, Michigan 38 at halftime. There were six ties in the first half and 10 lead changes. Each team at one time led by 7 points. 3-point Bearcat lead right now. Billy, your assessment.
Well, Jim, I think that Bob Huggins' team did a great job with their pressure defense. Even when they went to the small club and fell back into the zone, they were still pressing out of the zone. Michigan players never did adjust to it. They're going to have to go ahead and pull the ball back out, try to make Cincinnati chase them a little bit before they attack. They're trying to attack immediately on the first pass. Cincinnati is too good at the press to do that.
Saw Chris Webber, 10 points, 6 rebounds in the first 20 minutes. This man with the ball, Jalen Rose, has had some big second halves this year. Look out for him in the final 20 minutes.
And for Bob Huggins, he can bring Corey Blunt back in. He kept him on the bench a long time with those two quick fouls. Scott on the bench with 3, but he dodged that bullet very well.
Juwan Howard. Buford saves it to Blunt.
That was just the quickness of Buford. Weber was in excellent position to the offensive board and couldn't complete.
Van Exel faked as though he was going to alley-oop it and drove right past his man to draw the foul.
Jim, Van Exel's been too quick for anybody on the Michigan team. Here we see those stats, and Michigan shooting 58% and finding themselves behind in the game. But there's the reason why. They've turned the ball over, and those turnovers have really led to the difference in this ball game.
Billy, that was the third foul against Juwan Howard. Two-shot situation. Van Exel will have one more. He is the Nintendo champion on this team in the Super Technical Bowl. They take it with them, Billy, on the road. Play that computer game, and he was the champ this year.
Here's what's interesting, how that trap will jump right back at you. Here they are back into their matchup zone, looking to get an opportunity to trap out of it, and there's another turnover. Steve Fisher beside himself. He's going to go back with Talley and try to play the three-guard set.
There he is, Talley for King.
Now, King started this game hitting 3 real solid jumpers down in the wings where you want to have some shots available. This is going to free up Rose maybe to play that position some, because Talley will have the ball. That's a pretty good idea by Van Exel. It's just that Blunt didn't move to the basket.
Yeah, pick and roll not sure. Working that time. 7th turnover for Cincinnati.
I mean, there was the pick. There was just no roll. Every pass by Michigan seems to be one without any authority on it. There's a good two-handed chest pass, and that sets up a play.
Herb Jones. 6'4", shortest man on the front line, but their top rebounder.
Well, everybody from the Cincinnati club is quick getting off the floor. Jones, we saw Eric Martin. This man right here, Anthony Buford.
Jones, three-pointer. Blunt better be careful. Almost over the back of Howard.
You notice how Michigan didn't look to get that ball quickly up the floor. Taking away some of their confidence on transition.
Oh, he read that one perfectly. Herb Jones.
Jim, no authority on the passing. Steve Fisher may have to go back to that starting lineup. The Cincinnati has taken Jalen Rose out of this game. There again, picking up the dribble in a bad spot.
Tally.
Watch this cross-court passing against a team like Cincinnati going to get you in all kinds of problems. The ball has got to somehow get to the center of the floor.
Here comes Jimmy King. That last foul on Anthony Buford. His second.
Jim, this is the lineup that I think can best work for Michigan. They can go ahead now and put Talley in the center, Rose and King on the wings, and still have enough power inside with Weber and Howard if they never get in a half-court set. Weren't you impressed with Buford yesterday when we had a chance to talk to him? I mean, he's just an articulate guy, has his head on straight. You can see why he provides such great leadership for this team.
He told us when we met with him, Billy, I've got a feeling that Michigan is going to be looking past us.
Oh, they try to set up Jones over here on the back door cut. Pretty good job by Rose.
Buford takes the pick. Nelson wasn't ready for it. Two on two with Rose, the trigger man.
He didn't know
what Blunt. A block by Blunt.
He didn't know Blunt was behind him.
Oh. And Exel blows right by Weber.
Gave a little hesitation dribble and Weber bit on it.
King, they need the three.
You can see the Michigan players getting a little annoyed with each other, Jim.
Howard, he'll shoot two.
Look at some of the expressions on the faces of the Michigan kids. And maybe more than expression. First time we've seen this in this team. Going back to that Indiana game where they played so positively, of course, in the tournament. Now they're starting to question themselves.
You can see that. You're right, Billy. Two for Howard. That was the second foul on Terry Nelson. Billy, I want to tell a story about this young man signing with Michigan. We talked about it earlier. He was raised by his grandmother, Janie Howard, and she had to sign his letter of intent. He made the decision on November the 14th of 1990 before he went to school, 8 o'clock in the morning. She told him after he signed, you made the right decision going to Michigan. He said, Grandmother, why didn't you tell me that all along? She said, you're going to need to make some decisions. As Weber follows up, you're going to need to make some decisions one day on your own. Later that afternoon, while Howard was at school, his grandmother passed away of a heart attack.
And there is Chris Weber taking a page out of Duke's book. He slaps the ground defensively and said, guys, let's get into this thing. Martin, who really turned things around for Cincinnati, back in the game.
Blunt, he's put the ball on the floor a few times in this half. What a tip by Martin.
It's an explosive leaper.
Well, he's much bigger than 6'5".
Oh!
I didn't see that.
Well, it was Talley pushing off against Jones. Three men around the ball. Tally's got a hit ahead.
Second on Talley. Thought it might be a reach-in on Jones.
See right here, he pushes Jones out of the way. No question about it.
Perfect replay to prove it. We'll be right back. Officials time out.
This commercial is for people who expect their Chevy to do everything.
I go around. I was strong as I could be. I go around.
Nothing ever got to me.
The all-new Chevy Suburban, now with standard four-wheel anti-lock brakes and available five-ton towing.
Like a rock.
Chevrolet, the trucks you can depend on, the trucks that last.
Like a rock.
Yo, what's up? Sinbad here. This is my team.
I'm
we wearing black top, only outdoors. You see a team like this? I got my man Too Tall. Show me you Too Tall. That's this thing. I got my man Reg. Show him, brother. Woo! All up, man. Good man. Bigfoot Clemente, what kind of shoe you wear? Ogie, Ogie, Ogie. He just whips me in the head with that hair. Whip. Slim got to play outside. You put him inside, he gonna hurt somebody. Show him that 2-inch vertical, brother. And of course, I'm the man, Sinbad, the greatest outdoor player that ever lived. Reebok Blacktop.
You've got to be tough to run with this crowd. That's why 28 of 33 pit crews at Indy use Craftsman hand tools. Made in America. Guaranteed forever, only at Sears.
From a hero that's going to sock you a home run. Will that make you feel better, Johnny?
To a legend. There was only one. John Goodman, The Babe, rated PG. Starts Friday, April 17th.
Hey, you took the job.
Boy, are we glad you're here.
It's been a nightmare.
You know, we must have 10 different computer systems in this place. Good ones, too. But they just refuse to work with each other.
Well, of course, you've dealt with worse problems.
Yeah, we heard what you did at your last job. Getting all those different systems to share applications and databases. Nice tie. It's my boss.
Hey, maybe we could hook up later for lunch. Can you play racquetball?
Okay, Susan.
Someone new is coming to Late Night. Is he here to save us or destroy us? What is his secret? The answers, coming soon to CBS Late Night.
Call them the Fab Five or Five Times, whatever you call them. They're down five at the moment in the second half. The Cincinnati pressure D has been part of the story here, Billy.
Well, not only is it turning the ball over, but in the second half, Michigan's just 1-for-6, shooting 17%. They've been able to get into no semblance of an offensive set on half court. They'd like to have Martin with Chris Webber one-on-one.
Webber was saying it was off his forehead, off of Martin's forehead, but Hightower was there, and it's Cincinnati basketball.
Webber must have Martin by a solid 4 inches, but he's given up an awful lot of quickness on that first move that Martin puts on him. See if they try to take advantage of it. There he is.
Terrence Gibson back in for Cincinnati. Van Exel gives it back to Martin. Ball touched the back of the board. It's a turnover.
Now, what Bob Huggins is saying is that the ball was hit when it went up in the air off Martin's hand, and consequently, it should be Cincinnati ball. And that's what they're going to call. Everything going Cincinnati's way right now. You see the play. Van Exel makes the good dump. Good play by Webber. He'll go up. Now, see, the ball was hit by Webber before it hit the stanchion behind, so it's an excellent call.
Shot clock is under 10.
Now we're down to the five, and Jim, I'm going to go back to halftime. There is, what, 15-12 left in the game and not just the 5 seconds?
That's what you meant by wait a
go.
Minute.
There we go.
Van Exel.
Van Exel gets hit, and that's going to be a three foul shots coming up on this one. It's a three-point shot.
Tally got him. It's Tally's third personal.
You know, really, Van Exel, in this particular game and throughout the NCAA tournament where he has been so outstanding, is probably as fine, if not the best guard play of anybody in the tournament so far this year, has put the speed level at a level that Michigan can't handle right now. He's going by people, creating a lot of mismatches.
Struggling today from the line. Remember, he opened missing his first two. He's now 1-for-5. Nick Van Exel did not start the season at guard. In fact, not until some 14 games into the year did he replace Alan Jackson is the starting point.
But they're 18-1 since they made that move. And, you know, in talking to Bob Huggins about it, said it was just a matter of time. And he makes them tough to defend.
That's their largest lead, 7-point lead. King trims it right away to 4 with that three-pointer.
King is drilling his outside shots today, and a perfect man to set down in that low wing position. Back screen on Weber. Motion offense right here by Cincinnati.
Bounce pass to the corner. Van Exel gets himself some operating room. Missed the layup. Weber snaps it out to Talley. Goes behind the back to take the middle. Right into the arms of Howard.
Good break for Michigan. Jim, you notice how little Jalen Rose is touching the ball. Cincinnati could not have planned it better.
Almost invisible in the second half.
See, Talley's got the ball a lot. Once he breaks that press, he should get it back to Rose.
Three players around Jones. Is lucky to get that one out. Martin thought about popping the jumper. Now spins around Weber. And Blunt's going to be over the back.
Number 3 for Blunt. Huggins will probably let him go. He's got Scott on the bench, who was not particularly effective in the first half, picked up 3 quick ones himself.
Well, a moment ago, it was 50-43. Now 50-48, Michigan can tie it or even take the lead on this possession.
Now Michigan has to figure out a way to get the ball over half court and then get into their offense in the low post. They have not been able to do that the entire game.
Jimmy King.
Still haven't.
Rose able to race that one down. Rose wants it back.
See, that 2-3 matchup zone causing all kinds of problems.
How about Van Exel? Stripped it right out of his jump shot.
He's going all the way. And Jim, you look up at the scoreboard and you have a feeling Cincinnati in total control of this game, but that hasn't been the case. There's Van Exel coming from behind, just as Blunt did a time or two ago, being able to make the block from behind.
Van Exel taking the ball out of the hands of Rose. Jalen Rose. As we see Bosco back in. That was the 4th on Talley, so he'll sit.
And what this also means that with Bosco in, he and Jimmy King will play the wings, and Rose now will be required to handle the ball.
So after making the steal from Rose off the shot, Van Exel will shoot 2. Too bad these two couldn't have played on the same team. Could you imagine that rock and roll backcourt of Exel Rose and Van Jalen?
It's a reach.
You said I'd never go up with it.
And here they are.
16 again, for Van Exel, and Jones working on Rose on this trip.
Yeah, notice that try to wait till he gets over half court before they trap him. Here they come.
Soft touch by Weber. Back to a 2-point lead for Cincinnati.
And if Cincinnati gets in a game where they're trading baskets half court at a time, then it swings the balance back over to Michigan. Cincinnati needs to turn them over some. Jalen Rose will have his hands full with Van Exel's quickness. Double low post.
Jones missing over the two Giants. Bosco. Long rebound sets up the break for the Bearcats. Bosco from behind gets the steal.
Good hustle by Bosco.
This could tie it. Howard's blocked by Blunt. Oh! His second big one of the half. Van Exel. Jimmy King forgot Van Exel was a left-hander. He just gave him a little shoulder fake and came back to his strong hand. One of the few times today that Michigan has gotten the ball where it needs to go, right onto the foul line area, and then dumped down inside.
Rose, 3 out of 9 so far. Tip, I guess, Vasco. I thought the first tip was going in. I was going to give him credit for it, but two players in the area. But
Weber was doing a good job using his body to shield everybody out. Vasco couldn't deliver. See the shot. Now watch Weber on the inside. He's got everybody blocked out. He had a perfect situation for Vasco and might have blocked it a little bit himself.
Van Exel with his second foul, and Vasco to the line for two, Billy. He's an aerospace engineering major at Michigan, as we see Scott with three fouls back in for Blunt. Vasco had a class on Monday, the day after the overtime game against Ohio State, where he had to give an oral presentation on laminar versus turbulent boundary layers flowing over a rotating football. 10-minute speech. I would have loved to have heard the conclusion.
Well, that's a Bo Schembechler course. Is that what he's back there teaching that one? You know, he talked to this Michigan club after they turned the ball over 34 times against Detroit. That picked up their concentration with it.
An official's timeout.
You know, there's real magic in Diet Pepsi. It's got that special aha ingredient. You got the right one, baby. Okay, girls, now what's that magic ingredient?
Uh-huh. With 100% uh-huh.
When you've got something precious to carry, this is one way to do it. Here's another. Chevy Lumina Euro Sedan. Engineered with four-wheel independent suspension and standard anti-lock brakes. It's one way to help make sure your precious cargo is delivered safely. Chevrolet. The cars more people depend on. And now it's easy to win with the heartbeat.
It's a whole new feeling. Come see what we've done. It gets better and better at Sheraton.
At ITT Sheraton, we spent $1 billion to get ready for your next business trip. Come stay with us.
We spent $1 billion so you'll feel like a million at Sheraton Hotels. It's a whole new feeling.
These extinct relics of American business remind us that waste and inefficiency don't pay. And that while perhaps it used to be impressive to throw money around, today it's more impressive not to. A timely reminder from the only company that guarantees 10:30 overnight delivery for up to 40% less. UPS.
An Eyewitness to Murder is on the run for her life. A thriller that will take you to the edge of your seat and keep you guessing to the very end in the eyes of a stranger. Tuesday.
Jim Nance and Billy Packer, and we welcome you to Game 1 of the National Semifinals. Cincinnati is led by as many as 7. Second half field goal percentage, Billy, that's telling for the Wolverines.
It really is, and they have not been able to get the ball down the low post at all after shooting a good solid 58% in the first half. And Van Exel is on a tear. He started off hitting those jump shots. He's been too quick for any Michigan defender in the man-to-man. Had big games, you know, Memphis State hit 22, 8 for 11 in that game. Had 18 in the first game against Delaware, so it's not like we're seeing some today. He hasn't been doing every game in this NCAA tournament.
Here he is, dumping it inside to Buford, who's doubled up. Vasco now comes off of him.
Giving Cincinnati some of their own medicine there with a double team in the corner.
Buford spinning over Vasco. That was a force.
I think he thought he could take Bosco, had a little bit too much quickness on him.
Outside, a foul, a reach in on Van Exel, and that's his third. Team foul number five.
Now,
actually, that goes against Buford, and that's Buford's third. So Buford has three, Van Exel has two.
And here's a lineup that Bob Huggins goes to, takes Buford out of the game, and goes with his two big men. So this is the biggest lineup he can put on the floor. Scott and Blunt out there. You got 2 6-10ers on the floor, so Cincinnati becomes relatively big inside. See if this takes away any of their defense. Still playing that matchup zone and trapping out of it.
Howard passes to Weber. That Blunt snags the rebound.
Excellent quick leap that time by Martin to make Weber's shot tougher.
Outside, Blunt surprising everyone, and the rebound to Rose.
Jim, the worst thing you can do in basketball is take a bad shot because your teammates don't know it's going up, and they're not in position to rebound.
And it sets up that right there. It sets up a break that ties it. Jalen Rose now totaling 8 points in the game. Under 10 minutes to go. First game at the Final Four.
I'm not saying that Blunt can't make that shot, but nobody anticipated it. So nobody was there to go ahead and have good defensive block, offensive rebounding to get any rebound for it. Michigan was off to the races.
Martin. Oh, tough angle.
How about his hands?
Oh, what an angle.
Great hand.
Impossible. He has eight off the bench.
With the two big guys in the game, Jim, the traps have not been that effective.
Weber turns around, way short. On one bounce, Martin has the rebound. Alan Jackson back in. He handles the ball now for the Bearcats. In the backcourt along with Van Exel.
Well, that allows Van Exel to play number two guard, Jackson handling the ball.
Don't think I've ever seen a point guard with the number 52.
Well, you've seen guards. Don't guards sometimes have 52 in football?
Oh, offensive guards, yeah, right.
Michigan matches up with this team pretty good defensively.
I'm not sure Jackson's aware of it. Under five on the shot clock.
Lost his dribble.
Has to force it. Back to Martin.
Oh, Bosco, nice job.
Jimmy King.
That's a tough foul right there. Now Buford and Van Exel both got some foul problems. They both have three on them.
Jones and Nelson, two starters back in for Martin and Scott. Weber's out for Michigan and Riley back in.
And you can see that Bob Huggins gave a try to play both big men at one time, but their pressure defense really fell when they had that lineup out there. Now they come back with an arrested Nelson. And, of course, Herb Jones on the floor, too.
Buford comes in for Van Exel.
Now you can see what he's doing here, too. He doesn't want Van Exel, who's got that great quickness and is having the hot day offensively, to pick up that fourth foul with 8 minutes to go. So you probably hold him out for 2 or 3 minutes here.
King ties it at 56. A little more than 8 minutes to go.
You know, there's been an ebb and flow to this game, Jim. You feel now that Michigan's gaining a little confidence, that they haven't been turned over in a while.
Buford bounces it inside. Jones, turnaround. Howard had position on the rebound. His sixth. Jalen. Boskel. Tied it up. Arrow belongs to the Bearcats. That's the under 8 minute timeout on the floor. What a game to start out Super Saturday.
A tradition unlike any other. The Masters on CBS.
Maybe your first car shouldn't be a car.
I was 18, didn't have a care. Working for peanuts, not a dime to spare.
Get this Chevy S10 EL pickup with cash back for around $8,000. Chevrolet, the trucks you can depend on, the trucks that last.
The RCA Home Theater has a VHP picture tube which makes it seem like you're really there. And you can connect your Laserdisc, stereo, VCR, or camcorder to it without being a rocket scientist. And with the RCA Home Theater, you can get rid of your other remotes, too. Because it comes with Master Touch, the universal remote. Another way RCA is changing entertainment again.
Hello, Pizza Hut?
Come on, Pizza Hut,
together. Call Pizza Hut for the new Pepperoni Lovers Pizza with 25% more pepperoni than before. One medium's $8.99 and any other medium's just $4 more.
About to see how Goodyear is changing all-season driving right before your eyes. Introducing AquaTread, only from Goodyear. AquaTread's advanced design channels water out of your way for dependable all-season traction, especially in the rain when you may need it most. AquaTread, the newest reason why we say the best tires in the world have Goodyear written all over them.
You're watching CBS Sports coverage of the Final Four.
Well, today's women's Final Four. Western Kentucky advanced to tomorrow's finals and will play Stanford. Stanford for the third straight year upsetting Virginia. That's tomorrow at 4 o'clock Eastern Time. Andrea Joyce will be hosting. Brad Nessler and Ann Myers calling the women's championship game. Eric Carrillo will be there as well.
Jim, this is a tough game to figure out. Tie score, you've got a situation, turnovers favoring the Cincinnati club. Rebounds, Michigan's leading 35-22 on the boards. Cincinnati has not been out-rebounded so far in the tournament. They're getting destroyed in there today, but they still find themselves tied.
Another rebound for the Wolverines. Riley and Rose almost committed himself to a backcourt violation. Caught himself in midair.
Nice job by Voskal to take that ball into the center. And there's that zone matchup.
Howard picks up the loose change, and Michigan has a two-point lead with 7 minutes to go.
That's the second time in this half Howard has been the recipient of, in effect, a lucky play inside to score.
An 8-2 run for Michigan. Tough pass, Buford.
You can see some confidence building for the Michigan team. Those grimaces that were on their face midway through the first half are giving way now to look good, solid performance.
Offensive foul on Riley, pushing off for position, his second. At the conclusion of every tournament game here in Minneapolis, we will be selecting a Chevrolet player of the game. In conjunction with the award, Chevrolet donates a $1,000 scholarship to the general scholarship fund of each school. Eric Martin has come back in, Billy. Let's keep an eye on him for Cincinnati.
Well, he and Jones make it tough down inside because they're so good in low post.
Three-pointer. Martin.
Martin again.
Gives him the second chance. Buford in the lane. On the hands. Rose with the foul. His second.
Well, Buford talked about going down to the city of Detroit. He's from Flint, Michigan, playing an awful lot of summer league ball. Rose, of course, of a player that's played so much summer league basketball and that AAU basketball that they've both played and gained a great deal of experience.
Weber coming back in. Buford said he's been hearing where Weber says they played together in some of those summer league games. I don't remember him. You've got to remember Chris Weber if you've ever been in a game with him. But Buford has played for a national champion before, 1986 and 87. He was on the national AAU champion team from Michigan with Derek Coleman, Mark Macon, Anderson Hunt, Doug Smith, and Steve Smith. How about that team?
I don't like that team. I mean, how can you put that group of guys together and not win it?
Really?
All the rest are in the pros.
I thought you were going to say you don't like that team. You love that
team. I guarantee you. Bosco putting the ball on the floor a lot.
Buford has tied it at 58, nearing the 5:30 mark. Bosco showing confidence. Score the basket, and he'll shoot one.
Jim, you hit it right on the head. He has come into this game with a confidence that the other players are starting to pick up on. And we're talking about a man that was a starter at the beginning of this year. And one of the real tributes to Steve Fisher's coaching has been the fact that the fellas that were unseated as former starters on this club have really stayed on the bench with a positive attitude. Riley, we saw get his chance against Oklahoma State and deliver. Voskal is delivering today.
Three-point play and a three-point lead for Michigan. Van Exel with his fourth foul.
I would say this time down the floor, get Van Exel into it somehow. He's been too quick for Michigan when he's touched it.
In a jam, Buford had it blocked. Bosco gets it out of the trap to Rose.
Beautiful.
Here we go. Wolverines now gaining confidence.
Bob Huggins said, I've seen enough for the moment.
Timeout, Cincinnati.
This royal throne of kings, this happy breed of men, this earth of majesty, this little world.
The airline that's uniting the world, United, brings you nonstop service from six U.S. cities to London's Heathrow and the land of poets.
This blessed plot, this earth, this realm, this England.
Come fly the friendly skies.
Microsoft Word for Windows is so easy. It just takes one click to make your work look twice as good. Microsoft Word, the word processor for Windows.
Getting to know you. I drove literally every car in the same class, and it boiled down to I wanted a Geostorm.
Guys like a girl that knows how to drive a stick.
There's 140 horses in here. Can you believe? Hello? Horses.
The cockpit's laid out like a jet.
You don't have to be a race car driver to drive a Storm, but you sure feel like one.
Get to know the new 140-horsepower Geo Storm GSI right around the corner at your Chevrolet Geo dealers.
If this car had wings, it would fly.
Point of fact, it takes the average person an average of 20 keystrokes to do an average task with their PC. Counterpoint, you can do it with just a point and click with Microsoft Windows.
Listen here, because Ray's got a big announcement for you. See, that special AHA ingredient is so popular, we're making April National AHA Month.
AHA will be everywhere this April. Grocery stores, restaurants, beaches, parks, everywhere. And to kick it off, we're sending 1 million lucky Diet Coke drinkers a free case of Diet Pepsi. Guaranteed delivery by UPS.
It's the celebration of the year, baby. You got the right one, baby.
With 100% AHA.
A car crash traps a young girl in a blazing inferno.
She was pinned in. I needed help. I needed a miracle.
Rescue 911 Tuesday.
Chris Weber will give you a cutaway shot, as we call it in our business. After the dunk, put him up five.
The expressions have changed, Jim, and so has the confidence level of Michigan. And I think a very wise timeout by Bob Huggins. He cannot let this game get away from a team that has played extremely well here today. In my estimation, Van Exel's the man that they've got to give an opportunity to score for.
5 minutes to go. Michigan by five.
He's setting screens on the inside.
Terrence Gibson.
Good defense and good patience. There he is. Just too much size in there.
Loose ball tied up, belongs to Michigan. The arrow belongs to the Wolverines.
Bob Huggins got it to the man that he wanted to have that ball, but Van Exel had to make too many moves to get inside, and then there was so much size in his way.
Michigan's turnovers in the second half, they had to get back into it, down seven at one time.
I think one of the keys to that, Jim, has been attitude. Instead of trying to make huge plays, long passes, they're now starting to get more solid.
Reach in by Jones. His first, team foul number eight. It'll be a 1-1. I saw those shots of Chris Webber, and it reminded me of the Oklahoma State game, Billy, where he fouled out. And he was so intense on the bench, trying to cheer his teammates on to advance to the next round. They tagged him with the nickname ML Carr. And a couple of times he almost hurt some teammates, grabbing him by the neck, coming off the court in excitement, trying to get him pumped up. Here's Buford back in.
They promised him that would not be his last game, and of course there was nothing he could do about it sitting over there on the bench. His that foul trouble, but his teammates came through for him.
His roommate at the line, Rose, told him, don't worry about it. You've not played your last game of the season. We're going to win it. And they did win that game. And then they won in overtime against Ohio State. And today they've come back from seven down in the second half. This free throw could put them ahead seven.
And Jim, getting down at crunch time, it's interesting that of all people, Isaiah Thomas talked to this Michigan bunch and said, there's Boskel again coming up with a big play. But Isaiah talked to this club on time and said, the last 2 minutes are where the game is played with the heart. And this team is getting down to that point right now. Showing a lot of it. And I think right here, if they're looking for a MVP of this game today for Michigan, it's been Boskel off the bench. And again, a tribute to Fisher. He just kept playing with the parts of his puzzle until he finally found one that would work.
Blunt was assessed as fourth. Boskel will shoot one more. Blunt with four. Van Exel with four. And Scott comes back in for the Bearcats.
The Great Midwest Conference puts a team in the Final Four in its first year in existence. You have to go all the way back to 1977 when UNC Charlotte went from the Sun Belt.
That was the last year Cincinnati was in the tournament before this year. They were Al McGuire and Marquette's first victim in their championship run in the 77 tournament. They had not played in the tournament in 15 years.
And had beaten Marquette that year in regular season, but not when it really counted.
Jones, a much needed three. Oh, how clutch was that?
Good step out by Jones. Everybody had been cutting to the basket, and the low post was well covered.
Cuts it to four, under four to go.
See, what Boskel's doing is penetrating and taking the ball back to the middle. Look at the difference between his passes and the floaters that have been thrown by King and Rose.
They reached in. Buford forced the steal. They get it back ahead to him. Boskel, obvious basket interference. It's a two-point game. Michigan by two, 65-63.
How about the smart play by Buford? He looks back behind him to see if there's anybody coming before he makes the play. There's another floating pass. That'll get you in deep trouble.
Timeout, Michigan.
Michigan called the timeout. They had a quick double or triple team on Boskel at midcourt, so timely indeed for Steve Fisher, leading by two.
In 1902, a new company changed the way America thought about the automobile. Now, on our 90th anniversary, Cadillac continues this tradition with the award-winning Seville STS, the limited edition Stars and Stripes Eldorado, and the advanced new Allante, pace car of the Indianapolis 500. Join the celebration at your Cadillac dealer now. It could change the way you think about American automobiles.
Salutes the Olympic athletes who found a better way. Whose ideas were so original, there's no going back. That same innovative thinking led us to invent Scotchgard brand Protector, and things have looked newer longer ever since. 3M, innovation working for you.
Where do you want to be next year?
You know, I don't plan to be a partner in this firm forever. In fact, I've been doing something on the side that could be very rewarding. I have an offer to work full-time with some kids. Pays $11,000 a year. How can we restructure my portfolio so I can tell them yes?
You can get there from here with Shearson Lehman Brothers.
Welcome to McDonald's. May I take your order?
What's cooking?
Well, sir, the Wild West has returned to McDonald's.
Oh, you don't say.
Uh-huh, so you could start the day with a hearty combination of tomatoes, peppers, and sausage in our 99-cent breakfast burrito.
Oh, no.
And stop back later for tender strips of grilled chicken with fresh tomatoes and cheese in our 99-cent chicken fajitas.
Come on, Wishbone! Pull your horses! I'm still talking to the sign!
What you want is what you get at McDonald's today.
Wednesday night is the new Royal Family, followed by Davis Rules. But you know what? I bet all the men in America are going to tune in just to see you, Jackie.
I know.
Wednesday.
Each team with two timeouts remaining.
Jim, one of the things we have to think about the rest of this way is free throw shooting. Neither one of these teams are good free throw shooting clubs, both at 65%. But one key factor is that Cincinnati will be shooting two on the next foul. Boy, there's a lot of passes that don't have zip on them, and that's what a trap would like to pick off. Matchup zone again. Laying back a little bit, not coming out the trap.
Fosco, three-point.
Oh, man. No way. Bob Huggins says, how can you let that man open? Remember the first game we did, Michigan and Duke? At that point, Steve Fisher said he's our best perimeter shooter. And here we are, almost a whole season has passed, and he comes to the front.
Reach. Jimmy King, yep, reached in. His second and the seventh against the Wolverines. So a 1-1.
Well, on the matchup zone, the last time down for Cincinnati, and Bob Huggins are really on his club. They were very passive, not trapping aggressively like they did in that first half when they had Michigan completely confused.
Corey Blunt. He was Basketball Times Junior College Player of the Year last year.
But he's this year a 55% free throw shooter.
6'10 center, 1-1. Oh, big one.
Line driver. And there is the comedian on the team who finds nothing funny at this point in the game.
Terry Nelson, that is. One more for Blunt. '68-'64. Mason Blue. Weber crashes, comes back out to King.
And Steve Fisher is screaming to his play keep away. He wants the ball. Oh, back. Almost picked off by Buford. He wants to force that trapping defense to get spread out so you can make a pass.
Martin fouling Howard. Three on Martin. Team foul number 9, so 1-1 for Howard.
Foul is charged number three, Eric Martin. His third, team's 10th.
I mean, make that 10 team fouls, and that is important because instead of...
Sure is.
If it was 9, it would be a 1-1. Now, and with it being 10 team fouls, it's a two-shot situation.
Jim, I often think for teams that are not good free-throw shooting clubs, that's really important. To know that you've got another one coming gives you that little bit of confidence.
Tremendous advantage on the boards for the Wolverines.
As I said before, Cincinnati had out-rebounded every opponent in this tournament coming into today.
Hit them both. Michigan by six.
Well, they've got the Fab Four and one out here now.
The one being Bosco. Ray Jackson, the freshman that's not in there now. Buford, three-pointer.
Beautiful. Oh! Beautiful arch on that shot.
You liked it all the way. Jones hit one a moment ago. Now Buford cuts the lead in half to three.
He may be a Superman, but after 75 fastballs, even Nolan Ryan's muscles can ache.
After the game, it's Advil, and those aches are long gone.
Today, it isn't aspirin or Tylenol acetaminophen. It's Advil. Advil, advanced medicine for pain.
The tingle feels like it's taken away the dandruff. That's me taking the Denorex shampoo test. I love that tingle. It convinced me to switch from Head & Shoulders to Denorex.
Denorex with conditioners. The dandruff shampoo you can feel working.
I'm a Denorex guy now.
Yo, Sinbad here with the black top shoe. I got my boys here from the International Committee. I got Schwinn and Schwinn. I'm trying to get the outside game prior to summer games here in Barcelona, right? Tell me you don't love this game. Look at this game. Come on, give my man a monster swing.
Play 60. Got it?
Let me see my black top shoe. I mean, you can't beat this. This is made for the outdoor game.
How do you pick the team, bro?
How do you pick your teams? You call games.
I got game.
No. I got game.
I got game.
No, you ain't never get a game. So, we definitely going to Barcelona this summer? Is that too much to ask for? Am I asking too much here?
What does $1 billion worth of service feel like? At ITT Sheridan, it feels like this.
We spent $1 billion so you'll feel like $1 million at Sheraton Hotels.
Let me get this straight.
When you got me to switch from AT&T, I gave you a list of my friends and my family.
Then I give you the names and numbers of my friends and my family.
Kenny wants the names and numbers of my friends and my family. I don't want to give those out.
At AT&T, your friends are your business. Keeping you connected to them is ours. So if someone wants the names of your friends and your family, simply say,
it's just not worth it.
It's just not worth it.
It's just not worth it.
To order the 1992 NCAA Championship Highlight Video, call 1-800-999-VIDEO. That's 1-800-999-VIDEO for the 1992 NCAA Championship Video.
Nighttime in Minneapolis, the Metrodome. Michigan leading by three. Cincinnati getting a three-pointer a moment ago by Anthony Buford, then calling a timeout. So the Bearcats have one. Billy, take us through some strategy here with 1:53 to go.
Well, Jim, one of the things that has hurt Cincinnati in the second half, they haven't not been able to press as much because they're only shooting 36%. But I think they have lived and died with this press. The rest of the way, it's going to be, can Cincinnati turn one over here, or can Michigan finally make a good play and maybe even come up with Cincinnati gambling with an easy basket?
Instant defense, Terrence Gibson, number 10, now coming in on Bosco, in for the Bearcats.
They're back to the man-to-man pressure here. Tough shot by Jalen Rose.
What a save by King. And a foul against Cincinnati. That was a tough shot by Rose. He almost got it, though.
Yeah, he took on the challenge from Anthony Buford. Probably not a smart move on his part, and got lucky as Jimmy King, his freshman teammate, comes up with a sensational save. There's the tough shot. You'll see King go flying out of bounds and get a piece of it.
And watch Buford, number 23, come over and commit his fifth.
He reached in and he has fouled out. They'll miss his leadership with 1:27 to go.
Jim, they still have him on the floor, so it must have been his fourth.
Okay. Oh, all right. Thank you. Stand corrected. Buford is in there.
Well, he
had originally announced. Our guy Mike Swanson heard the original announcement. They corrected it. I missed that.
That's
I apologize.
Okay. Five now. They've got to be thinking, get a two-point possession. And let's see if they do anything different. Get a two. You still got time enough to go for the three-point shot later.
Van
Exel takes the three.
They have position underneath.
That was Martin that got a hand on it. Now they're going for threes.
Buford, oh, gave it up at the last minute. Jones. Weber ahead.
Good pass.
Back to King. There it is.
Just as Christian Leitner, Jim, said last week, the catch was the most important thing. Weber looked that ball right in his hands and made the great catch on that play.
Out of bounds belonging to Cincinnati. 7-point lead with 43 seconds remaining.
As that ball was in the air for so long, you would have a tendency to look for the basket instead of catching the ball first. Weber did the fundamentally sound thing. Boy, Martin, who's been there all day.
Oh, almost had a three-point opportunity underneath.
Well, they're down seven now. They've got to force a turnover, and they've got to count on threes the rest of the way. I thought on that one possession, Jim, they had enough time to go for a two inside to Martin and then try a new three later. And they were really set on shooting three-point shots.
Gibson back in. Martin kept it alive with his ninth rebound. Big performance off the bench. Jackson in also for Buford. 35 seconds to go.
Well, what you think here is Bob Huggins is going to try to just put somebody in there for defense and bring Buford and Van Exel right back into the game. And that's taking a gamble with only 35 seconds to go. They're standing on the sidelines, as you can see, not sitting.
Two for Eric Martin.
Martin's been a 50% free throw shooter in the tournament, 55 on the year.
Perfect. Tally comes in. Voskal is out.
And Bosco gets a standing O from the Michigan faithful. He's been the guy that did it today for him.
Gibson reached in on Rose. Sent him to the line for two.
See what Bob Huggins is doing. Using his two offensive performers, using Gibson and Jackson to commit the fouls. Lengthen this game as best he possibly can. And we get back to the point that they will be shooting two. Makes it a little easier.
Go right back in. Rose at the line to shoot two. I asked Rose and Weber what they were doing 3 years ago when Michigan was at the Final Four in Seattle. And they said on that Final Four Saturday, we both were rooting for Illinois. We thought they were more exciting back then.
You know what's interesting, Jim? We talk about the game coming up with Duke and Indiana and everybody talking about the repeat. But I saw a stat that actually staggered me a little bit. The five freshmen from Michigan were all born in 73, which is the last time we had a team repeat.
That's right.
It's hard to believe. Jalen pounds the floor.
The margin is back to seven. 33 seconds to go. Michigan called the timeout. Steve Fisher's wife. We'll be right back. team has one timeout remaining. This remarkable group of youngsters that has really swept the country. Perhaps more popular than any team I've seen come on the scene since Phi Slamma Jamma 9 years ago. And they're now just 33 seconds from playing for the national championship.
Well, Jim, there's only one thing Cincinnati can do right now, and that is pray that Michigan can't drop their foul shots. What they're going to have to do is foul on their end of the floor, whether on defense, and go for three-point shots on offense. And the way that Jalen Rose hit the last two, and we saw a complete change in the facial expressions of the Michigan players midway through the second half, and it's continued right now. They're playing with great confidence. And a good job by Juwan Howard to step out, take away the three.
Buford, high-arching shot. Chased down by Martin, gives him another chance. Buford again. Blunt kicks it out to Van Exel. They want the three.
That's going to be a three and a foul shot.
Going to be a four-point opportunity.
Now, nobody has raised their hands.
Yes.
Now they have. What happened? A complete breakdown by Michigan's players when the ball went inside. Corey Blunt did a great thing, and Bosco got caught charging in and Nick the Quick put it up there. What a smart play by Van Exel.
He reminds me of Nate the Skate Archibald.
Extremely quick. Kenosha, Wisconsin native. But that was a case, you know, if you're Michigan, you've got to think and surround the three-point area defensively and let them make a two-point putback.
And he can cut it to three with 14 seconds remaining.
And you know what's going to happen on the inbounds pass. Go for the steal and foul.
Oh, big miss.
Oh, they get the ball back.
Under 10.
Nice screen by Blunt.
They don't have to have the three. Well, now they do. Time running out. It's over. Michigan is playing Monday night for the national championship. Billy, with 14 seconds to go after the missed free throw, Cincinnati still had one timeout. They could have kicked it inside, perhaps got a quick bucket and a timeout,
and then gone for the foul.
Michigan is set for Monday night. They want Duke. They've told us that. They want the rematch. They call it the ultimate game. They met earlier this year. It went into overtime. Pat O'Brien is coming up as we continue on CBS after this word from your local station.
This royal throne of kings, this earth of majesty, this little world. United brings you nonstop service from six U.S. cities to London's Heathrow. And the land of poets. This earth, this realm, this England. Come fly the friendly skies.
New York, 1939. They were four young women who wanted it all and began to find it at the Savoy.
I came here to dance.
Vanessa Williams, the naive one, longing for her shot at stardom.
I think I might be looking at my ticket out of Franklin Avenue.
I got a singing spot for you starting next week.
But never counting on the cost.
I am not a whore.
Lynn Whitfield, the reckless one, risking everything to escape her poverty.
I want the liquor license, and I'll do anything I have to get it.
I used to love you so much.
Jasmine Guy, determined to put her dreams on hold and make love work on her terms.
Let's get married.
Let's wait till you do get the job.
Vanessa Bell Calloway, a woman caught in the trap of forbidden love.
I love you. Don't you dare try to take it outside this room.
And Mario Van Peebles, the ladies' man.
You think I'm bad?
I hope so.
Debbie Allen directs an unforgettable world premiere movie about reaching for the chance at a better life. Stompin' at the Savoy, Sunday, April 12th.
This is CBS.
British Airways, the world's favorite airline.
Hurry in now for unbeatable values during Circuit City's truckload sale. Get 0% interest for up to 6 months on select top brand appliances. Take home this Whirlpool 18 cubic foot refrigerator with ice maker for just $599. And save $50 on this Whirlpool laundry pair, now $579. Don't miss these unbeatable values and more at Circuit City's truckload sale.
Welcome to Circuit City, where service is state of the art.
Join us for Eyewitness News.
Tonight at 10.
It will be Michigan against either Indiana or Duke on Monday night. Congratulations, Steve Fisher and Chris Weber. This is just a dream season for you guys. The freshmen are playing for the title on Monday. It wasn't easy today, I know.
Well, you know, we said it all along, but we believe it. And we know it's going to happen now. We're in the final game. And you really can't ask for much more except to win it. And I just thank God, you know, the Lord's just blessed our team a lot.
Steve, how did you guys come back from seven down in the second half?
Billy hit it on the head. James Voskel came in, and the tenor of our mindset seemed to change. We looked a little more under control and a little more poised, and we knew they were going to have some runs, but this big old rock in there, that helps a little bit.
Another double-double today. Billy?
Steve, in regard to the way Cincinnati played, I thought particularly in the first half, their press was almost awesome. It really threw you off stride, and it did take the ball out of Jalen Rose's hands. What were you thinking about with Talley coming in there and spreading it out a little bit?
Michael Talley is the point guard and knows how to play, and we just felt we could put him in, relieve maybe some of the pressure on Jalen, and have another ball handler that could relieve some of the stress for him.
And then it turned out that you go to Voskel, and he's the guy that sets the tempo to get you rolling in the second half, and he's supposed to be your best outside shooter and not the ball handler.
Well, we've had people come up big. Oklahoma State, it was Riley. Today, it was Voskel. To get where we are, that has to happen.
Well, here's a guy that's only lost one game in his life in the NCAA tournament.
He's 12-1. 12-1 now. He'll coach his 100th game at Michigan on Monday night. Chris, congratulations. Steve as well. And let's send it back over to Pat O'Brien.
All right, Jim, thank you. You get a sense of how big Chris Weber is there standing next to Jim Nance. Cincinnati came up short today. Leslie Visser caught up with Coach Bob Huggins in the hallway after the game.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm sorry. Coach, a gallant effort. In the second half, you led by 7 points. You were outscored like 20-8. How did it slip away?
We just let them rebound the ball. They got too many second shots. We still, I thought, were in great shape until Jalen Rose gets the rebound, foul, and makes two free throws. They just destroyed us on the boards. We just didn't get it done on the defensive glass. We just gave them too many second shots.
What about you forced a lot of turnovers in the first half? Do you feel your press was as effective in the second half?
The press wasn't effective because we didn't score. When you don't score, you have a hard time getting in the press. And we scored more in the first half, so consequently we're in the press. Score 41 points, you're going to have more of an opportunity to get in the press and get the press set up. But again, that wasn't the problem. The problem was we didn't rebound the ball. They beat us on the offensive glass.
What will you tell your kids? It was quite a remarkable run for Cincinnati this year.
We're going to be back. Contrary to what everybody thinks, we're going to be back. And, you know, we've got some guys coming back, and we've had a good recruiting year, and we're going to be back here again. So we'll live to fight another day.
Well, it was a great run for the great Midwest. Thank you, Bob.
Thank you.
And so the coach with a great attitude there telling our Leslie Visser, we're going to be back. We'll look for that. Our Chevrolet MVPs for this game, Chris Weber for Michigan, 16 points. And for Cincinnati, Nick Van Exel, who had 21 points on the night. And Mike, pretty good game.
Really was a good